Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another brand new Android Studio tutorial. Today I will show you how to use the Snackbar in Android Studio. So now we are in the basic activity, and here I have the basic activity in the Android Studio, and we don't have to do anything in the layout file in order to play with the Snackbar. So let's go to the main activity.java, and we have everything written by default when we are starting the basic activity. And as you can see, here is the floating action button, and inside that it uses the snack bar as a result of the floating action button click. So if you're in the empty activity, then first you have to go to the Gradle, and inside the module app Gradle file you have to add this support dependency in order to get the snack bar into your empty activity file. So if you're in the basic activity, it will be automatically added each and every items. So you can see here is the snack bar, which is we have discussed about the snack bar. We have seen the preview of the snack bar inside the Android application. So today I will show you how to create the snack bar, and we can see here is an action for the snack bar. This is going to be a button right side of the snack bar inside the snack bar itself. And finally we are going to give an action for the snack bar button click. So for this instance, I'm going to remove the snack bar and write everything from the first step. So first of all, I'm going to type snack bar, and now adding a dot, and we have the make. So type make, and you can see it uses the view and the character sequence, then text, then integer type, and something like that. So this is going to be the, finally it is going to be the duration, as we have done same as in the case of the toast. We have to use the view, so click on the first one, or you can just press the enter on the keyboard. So we can see it, you in the inside the one click listener, it is the view. Here is a view, and the variable name of the view as same as the view. So we have to type view in order to make the snack bar view. So we have to add the view, then add a comma, and you have to enter the message you want to display. So I just want to give it as, so as we know, the snack bar is going to display when the fab is clicked. So I'm going to just show a message that is you clicked the fab, and after that I'm going to add a comma again, and next we have to give the duration. So I'm going to give it as length, snack bar length. So snack bar length long. So here it says snack bar length long. You can use the short or long, like same as that we have done in case of the toast. And once that done, we have to add the action. So we have to just add an ender, then we have to type set action, and now we have to type the character, that is just go to some kind of files, or just okay, or just show toast. So I just want to show a toast when the snack bar action is clicked. So once that done, we have to add the method to get the toast. So inside the snack bar, we can't able to directly add the method or just give an action for this click listener of the snack bar. So that is the set action. So in order to give an action for the short text button inside the snack bar, we have to call a method. So I just want to create a new method called something like, for example, I just want to give the method name as short toast method. So now once that done, we have to just add a, finally we have to show that. So I'm adding the dot show, and after that I'm going to create a new method that is public. Then I'm going to use the keyword type as class, so that we can able to call it inside this snack bar. So public class, then give the name as short toast method. And now we have to add implement, then view dot one click listener. So what we are going to do is, as we can see here, it uses the one click as view. So we have to implement inside the method, we have to implement the view dot one click listener. So we have to double click on the first one, which is one click listener, and once that done, we have to add a curly braces. And now you can see it shows some errors. So all we have to do is click the mouse over the text, and press Alt Enter on the keyboard and implement that method. So just press Enter, which will pop up this window. You have to click on the OK, which will automatically add the one click listener inside this method. So now we can see here is a one click listener, and all we have to do is you can able to do anything inside this one click listener. So as we have given the title for this method as show toast method, so I'm going to add a toast. You can give any action for this method, and this is just a variable name, and it doesn't matter if it contains a toast. Then you don't really have to use the toast itself inside this one click listener. You can use anything as you want. Now I'm going to add a message like you clicker snack bar action. So now you can see I have added you click snack bar action as the message for this click listener. So it will show a toast when the snack bar action button is clicked. Before calling this method, we have to add a new. So new, and finally we have to add the brackets, and that's it. In addition to this, if you want, you can also add one more thing, that is dot set action text color, so that you can able to change the text color of this action button inside the snack bar. I'm going to use it as color, then dot red or yellow. I want to go with the yellow. So let's go and run this app in our live device and check that out. So guys, we have the Android application in our live device, and when I'm pressing the fab, that is the floating action button, you can see it shows that snack bar, and yeah. And when I'm pressing the show toast, you can see it shows the toast message. So that's it. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you in my next video.